What's up, food family? It's your boy Cleese. I'm back with the team that loves cuisine. You know how it is. OG John and Don, OG Tezzy. We keep getting it in. Yo, today we about to hit up a spot where me personally, I believe all cuisine originated from. And it just morphed into something different as it went to different cultures. Hey, either you in line or we can go ahead and chat about it. It don't matter how it go. But one thing I do know is that it's vast. It has a lot of different, flavors and tastes depending on which region you are in this spot. So we about to go ahead and touch down and taste some African cuisine.
What's good, food fam? We out here today, downtown KC. Clee, John in the back. About to go to, what's the joint called?
Awaze.
It's called Eskcobar now.
Okay.
Yeah, we were on the wrong street, driving in circles, trying to figure it out. Come find out, we was just in a completely wrong place, so. But yeah, the environment, downtown KC, you hear everything going on. I'm talking as loud as I can. Environment, traffic everywhere, construction. I mean, it's nice, bunch of businesses, but I mean, it's a typical downtown KC feeling. Tattoo shop, all kind of stuff. But about to go check it out. This will be our second African joint in like a few weeks, so I'm interested to, you know, see how it compares to Wagwan and Taste of Caribbean we went to. So. Stay tuned.
So check it out, food family. We're at the spot, we're sitting down enjoying our aqua. Music is banging in the background. Definitely giving you that island vibe.
Yep.
I'm really digging the music feel. You can tell that COVID has hit a lot of businesses different. You can almost tell there's a lot of businesses now that are running or short-staffed. That's kind of what we're running into here. Just got one young lady who's working the bar. We got about three tables, four with patrons, so she's trying to take care of everybody. So we understand, but as customers, you know, we still like our food. We like to order in a reasonable fashion. So we're hoping that it balances out, that the wait is worth it. Tune in, we'll let you know.
Will it balance out? Tune in.
What's good, y'all? We've been here. We've been waiting to take our order, and our waitress was actually nice enough to bring samples of the juice that we were asking questions about. We had mango lemonade. We had sorrel, which is like some kind of fruity lemon. Was it like, what was it?
Ginger. Hibiscus flower, ginger.
Oh, not lemon, yeah, but ginger. Hibiscus flower. And strawberry lemonade. And I would say my favorite so far is the mango lemonade, because it was fire. But yeah. It was fire.
He'll probably go strawberry, but I'm going mango.
Yeah, but I mean, as far as, you know, the food, the what we got so far, I mean, it's living up to the hype so far. So, I mean.
Really excellent customer service to bring that out.
Yeah,
what we get,
yeah, really.
Family, we back. I ordered the appetizer. I ordered some sambusas. They have one meat, one veggie. This is the veggie, and it's got lentils, it's got chickpeas, it's got onion, it's got jalapeno, bell peppers, herbs, and spices. I'm just gonna get into it. It's crazy. I had to re-record this because Clee was talking in the background to a new homie of the channel. And I'm glad I got to take a second bite, because that's how good this is. the dough is flaky, like what you would expect, like baklava or a croissant. The filling is flavorful, it's well seasoned. When they say herbs and spices, there's herbs and spices in this for sure. It is not under seasoned, let me tell you that right now. This sauce, I don't even know what it is, guys. I cannot tell you what's in this sauce. Maybe the proprietor can tell us a little bit later, but it has a little bit of heat to it. It's got like a tomato-y flavor to it as well. Everything about this so far, A1.
What's up, food family? It's your boy Cuisine. Like I said, don't feed me no bull. We over here at the spot. The young lady brought out some complimentary bread and a new dish that they're actually working around with. They're letting some of the patrons taste to see if they like it. But it's some type of olive oil. It's mixed with some seasonings that Ethiopians typically utilize in their cuisine. Berberry is that spice. So let me go ahead and check this thing on out. It looks like something that normally goes with a salad or something like that, but hey, let's see what it do. Well, the bread is very crispy, so therefore it ain't really being able to absorb as I want, so you probably have to break that outside first. Let me check it out.
Oh yeah, it's good. Yeah, you hear that crunch.
First up, that bread is fantastic. Crispy on the outside, really soft.
Mm-hmm.
Firm on the inside. It's not doughy. Let me go ahead and dip it again. See if I can get it in the meat area. There we go. Yo, I'm liking the seasoning, man. It's doing what it do. I definitely recommend y'all. Hey, up here at Eskcobar, put this on your menu. I think people will enjoy it.
The sauce on this was so crazy. It was spicy, it was sweet, chock full of vegetables, tomatoes and onions and everything else. The fish was flaky. It's not better than a walleye or a bass or something like that. That's just me. And it's super bony, so like, be prepared to put in the work to eat this fish. All that being said, I wouldn't order it again because of the work, but it was worth the work, if that makes any sense. This was such a pleasurable experience as far as really getting to experience somebody else's culture, like whole fish meal. I also got the lamb curry. I only took a bite of that because the fish filled me up and because I know my wife likes curry, but really flavorful, really tender. My personal opinion, the lamb is slightly overcooked, but flavor, I got no complaints. But let me tell you the best thing that I ate today. Cabbage. I can't believe I'm saying that, but the best thing I ate today is not a protein. It is this side dish. I wish I remember what it was called, but it had cabbage, it had boiled potatoes, it had carrots, a number of seasonings in it. It was the first thing I tasted, and it was also the first thing gone because I didn't take a bite of it. I don't think anything else until that cabbage was gone. That's how fire it was. in the intro, you probably heard us joking about starting out at 8 out of 10 because it was cash only, this, that, and the third. Let me tell you something. This place is gets a Show Me Cuisine. They're going to back me up. 10 out of 10 Show Me badges. Point blank, period. When your food is this good, it makes up for all the other things, like how long the wait was for the food, or, you know, or the cash only thing. Zero complaints about the overall experience here at Awaze. Done and done.
John said, yeah, I mean, we waited. We've been here for, what, 2 hours now?
Easy.
Yeah, and I honestly, I would complain if it was any other place or if the service wasn't as good as it was, the food wasn't as good as it was, but they came through. They really pulled through. Like, the stuff was made fresh. I had got plantains, lamb tips, the mixer, split peas, and of course I got the cabbage that John was talking about as well. And man, when I tell you, like S-tier cabbage, never in my life would I ever say it. Just like that, never in my life would I say, you know, I would be craving cabbage or something like that. And this cabbage was fire. Like, when we say that was the first thing we ate off of our plates, out of all the chicken, out of all the lamb, out of everything, first thing going off our plates, it was that good. And like, I'm not even a vegetable person. I'm sure they meat eaters too, just like, you know, me. So when it comes to vegetables, fire. I will say my lamb was really good. My lamb, it was cooked to my preference. It was well done. And of course, we used our hands to eat. It actually, all the food actually came on, what do you call it? It actually came on these. It was a giant. I'll actually show y'all. The whole platter was covered with it. So basically, you just ripped it off, baked the lamb, the split peas, cabbage, all of that into one. I even had like onions, there was some jalapenos in there. It's a heck of an experience, like a whole cultural jump for me. Like, I can't complain. I mean, not one bit. At first, like, you know, we were joking around about taking points off, but it was definitely S tier. So.
Yo, what's up, food fam? As you seen when I prepped before, I said, don't feed me no bull. Man, come on.
Come on, cup.
These folks knocked it on out the park. I went ahead and went with the curry goat. First time ever tasting goat. I ain't no goat. I used to let the mic smoke. That mug was delicious for him. I'm talking about it snapped, it popped. Thought it was cereal. Now, like my guys was chopping it up, even the side, everything that was about it, from the vegetables being cooked correctly, to the sides, to the split peas, it was perfect. Even talking a little bit about the cultural way on how they eat it, to where they would bring it out, as Tezzy explained it to you, on what looks like a brown pancake, and pretty much it's all hands on. Utensils out. These is it right here, what God gave you. Dip in, grab it, let's get it going. I love everything about it, from the vibe here, the music, the customer service was A1, and we even got an opportunity, which I believe to be either possibly the chef or management came out and talked to us a little bit, asked us what we thought about the meal. We told them exactly what we thought. We thought it was fantastic. The drinks to wash it down, the whole overall experience, man. You got to get out here. This Ethiopian cuisine that they're serving down here is fantastic, bar none. Tune in for the next episode.
Cleve, before you cut that, I got a question for you. How is your cabbage?
Yo, am I tripping? How could I forget that cabbage? Now, if any of y'all remember some of my later episodes, one episode we had with me and Tez, we went to a German spot called Grunauer, and I was tasting this soup that they brought out, and it brought back memories of me going back to maybe like somebody's grandma, somebody's mother slaving in the kitchen and making something for the family. When I tell you, when I bit into that cabbage and those potatoes and those carrots, how hearty that cabbage was, the first thing I could think about, it almost brought tears to my eyes, was my mama and how she would prepare cabbage, typically with some type of roast. That's how delicious it was. Bar none, I'll come up here and just order some cabbage. That's how good it is. Outside of that, the jerk chicken, it was delicious. It was tender, it was juicy. Everything about today was perfect.
But you don't have to take my word for it.